This conference will now be recorded.
So, dear students, in the last class, we have gone through the basics of microscopy. Hope you all remember those things. So, regarding microscopy, we started, I will just recap the last session. We started with the basics of microscopy. We talked about normal light microscope, then electron microscope and its magnification power. We also told about the light source which we are using in light microscope and electron microscope. Also about the range of light, that is about the range of visible light, range of UV light, all those things we discussed. Then we started off with basic terminologies in microscopy such as transmission, reflection, diffraction, absorption, then fluorescence, then refraction. Then we discussed about refractive index. Then we discussed also about the shape of lens and how it affects the focus or magnification. Fine. We also discussed about various types of aberrations or abnormalities in microscopy, that is about spherical aberration. Then next one, we discussed about chromatic aberration. Also, we discussed about the two types of lenses which we use in microscopy basically, that is ocular lens or eyepiece lens and objective lens, or lens which is situated near the object or specimen. Numerical aperture, fine. All those things we discussed. And finally, we discussed about the oil immersion lens and its work, and also about the term contrast. So these are the things which we have discussed, or these are the points which we have discussed in the last slide. So now we are going to the second session of microscopy, fine. First slide, please. Can you move the slide? Yeah, thank you. So now in this session, we are mainly going to discuss about various types of microscopes. So already I have explained you two types are there, light microscope and electron microscope. In light microscope, the source of illumination is light, whereas in electron microscope, the source of illumination can be a beam of electrons. Now, light microscope can be of different types. So different types of light microscope or advances in the field of light microscopy, we are going to discuss in this session. Fine. So we start with the common light microscope or bright field microscope. That is the first type of microscope we are going to discuss. Bright field microscope. So from the term itself, you can get some idea. Bright field microscope means the field will be bright. That is, when we observe a slide through bright field microscope, the field will be bright so that the object will be dark. Definitely, if the field is bright, the object will appear dark, and if the object is bright, the field will appear dark. That is a basic principle in microscopy. Fine. So you have got another microscope, that is after bright field microscope, when we go to dark field microscope, fine, then you will understand the difference. So let us start with bright field microscope or the common microscope which we have seen or which we have used in our laboratories. Fine. So bright field microscope, two types will be there again. Some of them they will run on electric power, that is it will be having a light, and some other microscope it will be running with sun's rays. So condenser lens we will used to focus the sun's rays. Okay, so the first point, the choice of a microscope depends upon the nature of specimen, size of object, degree of detail, purpose, etc. So which microscope we have to select, it depends upon first of all the nature of specimen. What is the nature of our specimen, whether our specimen is a live organism or it is a stained slide. Fine. Size of the object, whether we are going to observe a bacterial cell or whether we are going to observe an algal cell or a fungal cell, or even we are going to observe the cell structure of a bacterial cell, all those things will depend. Then degree of detail, so the same thing, what is the degree of detail? If we are going to observe only the size or shape, or we are going to observe the shape of a cell, okay, coccus, round, bacillus, or rod shaped, spiral shaped. So if we are going to observe the shape only, we can go for either bright field microscope or dark field microscope or fluorescent microscope or phase contrast or whatever it is. But if we are going to observe the internal cell structure of a cell, then definitely we have to go for electron microscope. Also, if you are going to observe viruses, we have to go for electron microscopy. So all those things, the choice of a particular microscope depends upon all these factors, purpose, all those things, fine, right? Nature of specimen, size of object, degree of detail, purpose, etc., 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 fine. For example, already I have explained, certain microscopes are used to view stained specimens while certain others are used to view live organism. So sometimes we can even observe live organism. Hope some of you, at least some of you, have are remembering about the term motility. You might have done in your UG classes, motility experiment, that is motile organism, organisms with flagella. When we observe through a light microscope, we can see moving organisms, motility test. Some of you might be recollecting it, fine. So some microscopes are used to view live organism, where some microscopes we are used to view stained specimens or stained slides, fine. Now, certain microscope again depends upon fluorescent stains to observe specific microorganisms or structures. So sometimes we are using some fluorescent stains. So fluorescence, already we have studied about the term fluorescence. Hope some of you remember in the last class, what is fluorescence? What is fluorescence? So fluorescence was, that is light of one wavelength we are using to, and it is giving light of another wavelength. That is light of one wavelength is absorbed and light of a different wavelength with low energy level is emitted. That is fluorescence. So fluorescence microscope also we are using, fine. Now we are going to start with bright field microscope. So bright field microscope, as I have already told you, it is the common type of microscope which we see in most of the laboratories, or in all laboratories there will be at least one bright field microscope. It's a common microscope. Sometimes it runs on electric power with a light source. Sometimes it runs, we can focus the sun's rays, and then we can observe the bacteria. So it's a common type of microscope. It uses visible light. So about visible light, we have discussed in the last class, what is the range of visible light, 400 to 700 nanometer or something. Already we have discussed all those things, fine. So in bright field microscope, the illuminating source is a light source, which is nothing but visible light source, clear? Now, require staining of specimen. So bright field microscope, we are using mainly to view stained specimens, not live organism. Bright field microscope, we are observing stained specimens or stained slides, gram staining or symbol staining or acid fast staining or spore staining or flagellar staining. Whatever staining technique we are doing, after staining, after drying of the slide, we are observing it with bright field microscope. Clear? Now, they are rarely used to observe live microorganisms. Already I have explained. As the class progresses, we will learn about some other microscopes which we use to observe live microorganisms. Clear? Now, the next point is the most important point in bright field microscopy. Specimen appears dark or colored on a bright field. Field means background. So when we observe a slide under microscope, what we see, the surroundings, it is the background. It is called field of a microscope. Sometimes when we observe, we cannot see any organism. Means we are out of field. The slide is out of field. We cannot observe the organism, fine. So we use the coarse adjustment and fine adjustment to bring it on the proper field, clear? So hope all of you remember about coarse adjustment, fine adjustment, all those things, clear? So in a bright field microscope, the most important thing is the specimen or the slide or the organism which we observe, it always appears dark or colored on a bright field, that is on a bright background. So specimen appears dark or colored, whereas background or field appears bright. That is its characteristic feature of a bright field or light microscope or bright field. It's the same. It is the light microscope or bright field microscope. It is one and all the same. Clear? Now it consists of a light source. Already I told you, it can be either electrical light source, you will have a bulb which is fitted in the microscope, or you can even, some of the microscopes, it does not run on electric power, it will be having a condenser lens like any other microscope. So using the condenser lens, we focus the sunlight. So under the sunlight, we can observe the specimen. So it consists of a light source, clear, Then condenser lens to focus light on the specimen. So what is the function of condenser lens in a microscope? It is used to focus the light on the specimen. When we tilt the condenser lens, the light will go out. When we place the condenser lens properly, it can directly focus the light on the slide or the specimen. Clear? Then two types of lenses already we have studied. What are the two types of lenses in the microscope? Objective lens and ocular lens for magnification. What is magnification? Already all those things we have learned. That's why in the last class I just went through all the basic things. So if you have gone through that, it is very easy for you to follow in this class. What was magnification? Enlargement of image of an object, that is magnification. Clear? Enlargement, we can see the image in a, we will have a larger view of the image. So two types of lenses are there, objective lens and ocular lens. Now what is ocular lens? Ocular lens is nothing but the eyepiece lens. Through ocular lens we see, we observe through ocular lens. It is situated near our eye, which we into, through the ocular lens we look. Fine. Now ocular lens is usually 10x. So what is x? X stands for the magnification. Fine. So usually the ocular lens will be 10x, sometimes 5x ocular lens is also present. So ocular lens can be either 5x or 10x, whereas objective lens can be either 10x or 40x or 100x. So already we have learned all those things. If the ocular lens is 10x and objective lens is 10x, the total magnification will be 10 into 10, that is 100x. If the ocular lens is 10x and the objective lens is 40x, the total magnification will be 40 into 10, that is 400x, 400 times. Then finally, if the objective lens is 100 and the ocular lens is 10, the total magnification will be 1000x. And here, while we are using 100x, we already told you we were using oil immersion lens. So that instead of this 1000x, we can get a magnification of up to 1400x. That is, instead of 1000 times magnification using oil immersion, we can get a magnification of up to 1400 times. Fine. So magnification of 100, 400 or 1000x. Fine. Now specimen. Now the next point is again another most important characteristics of a light microscope or a bright field microscope or many microscopes. It is having the same phenomenon. That is, excuse me, the specimen focused with one objective lens remains in focus when switches to other objective lenses. Thus, the microscope is said to be parfocal in nature. So what do you mean by parfocal? So just recollect how you are using microscope. Once you keep the slide, you will use the course adjustment first so that the stage will move upward and reaches the correct position. Then you use the fine adjustment so that you can observe the specimen or the microorganism. Then without changing the course adjustment or fine adjustment, you will change the 10x objective lens using the nose piece and you will keep the 40x objective lens. You have to recollect this in your mind actually. Those who have used microscope can very well recollect this. You don't use the course adjustment, you change the 10x objective, keep the 40x objective and use only the fine adjustment. So now it is clear. After going through 40x, again you change the nose piece 40x. Before keeping the 100x, you put or place one drop of oil and then you keep the 100x over the oil so that the oil will spread over the lens. Again, you use the fine adjustment and then you can clearly visualize the cell shape and arrangement. Hope you all remember how you are using a microscope. So now you read the sentence. The specimen focused with one objective lens, for example 10x, remains in focus when switches to other objective lenses, that is 40x or 100x. Thus the microscope is said to be parfocal in nature. So that is what is called parfocal. That's a phenomenon of the microscope. Clear? Now oil immersion is used with 100x objective lens. Already we have learned why oil immersion we are using with 100x objective lens. So if we are using it with 400x, 10 into 400 the maximum, or 10 into 40 the maximum magnification we are getting is 400x. So if we are using oil immersion there, we won't get a better magnification. It will be something around 400 to 500. But when we are using it with 100x objective, excuse me, already the magnification is 1000x, and when we are using oil immersion we are getting a magnification of around 1400x. So that's why we are using oil immersion with 100x objective lens. Clear? And finally, the last point, typical resolution of a bright field microscope is around 200 nanometer. So resolution, resolving power, all those things we have learned in the last class. Again, I want you to go through all those things. What is resolution? Degree to which the detail in specimen is retained in the magnified image. So how much clear or how much proper we can visualize or we can see the magnified image. That is what resolution. And what was resolving power? Resolving power is the closest spacing between two points at which the points can still be seen clear as separate entities. So those who have not attended the last session, maybe they will have little difficulty in following this session, because all these basic terminologies we have discussed in the last session very clearly. Fine. So that is about bright field microscope. Fine. So next slide, please. Yeah, thank you. So in this slide, you can see the bright field microscope, how the light is passing. You can see the light source is from the bottom, either can be sunlight or another electric light source. It will come and hit on the condenser lens. The condenser lens will focus it on the specimen. Fine. And from the specimen, the light will pass through the objective lens. The objective lens will magnify the image. Again, it will pass through the eyepiece lens. The eyepiece lens will again magnify the image. And finally, it will reach the eye. So if the objective lens is 10x and eyepiece lens is 10x, the total magnification we can see is 100x. If the objective lens is 40x and the eyepiece lens is again 10x, the total magnification we can see is about 400x. And finally, if the objective lens is 100x and the eyepiece lens is again 10x, we will get a magnification of around 1000x. And finally, using 100x, when we are using oil immersion, we are getting a magnification of about 1400x, or we can magnify the image of the object around 1400 times than the normal image. Clear? Next slide, please. So this is a picture which shows how you can observe under bright field microscope. See, you can see colored specimen. The specimen appears dark or colored within a bright background. The background will be always bright. Clear? Of microscopes which we are going to see now. So already bright field microscope is over, and this is the basic thing, the simplest thing, and this is the base. And with this base, we can other type of microscope. Clear? So next one is dark field microscope. So in the bright field microscope, already we explained what we explained. The specimen appears dark or colored, whereas the field is bright. So here in dark field microscopy, what is the importance, or what is the variation? Here the field is dark, but the specimen or organism or background appears bright. Bright. Fine. Now, what is the specialty of dark field microscope? Just the reverse of bright field. In bright field, field is bright, specimen is dark. In dark field, the reverse. Specimen is bright, field is dark. The reverse of the bright field microscopy. I'm sorry if I have made some confusions there. Now, the same thing. Bright field microscopy, field is bright. Dark field microscopy, field is dark. So if field is dark in dark field microscopy, specimen will be bright. Whereas in bright field microscopy, if the field is bright, specimen will be dark in color. Clear? Now, what is dark field microscope? Designed to eliminate staining to achieve contrast. So here, there is no need of staining. Fine. We can even observe unstained cultures, or we can observe unstained slides using dark field microscopy. So we don't need stain. So in bright, so now you have to compare and learn, then only you can very well understand. Fine. First of all, the difference between bright field and dark field already I explained. Now the next one, in bright field microscopy, we need stained specimens or stained slides only we can observe. But here in dark field microscopy, no need of staining. Even we can observe unstained specimens or unstained slides. So designed to eliminate staining to achieve contrast. So what do you mean by contrast? Already I have explained contrast in the last class. What is contrast? Contrast is necessary to distinguish an object from surrounding background. So if we don't have contrast, we cannot visualize an object from the surrounding background. So in bright field microscopy, we are performing staining to improve the contrast, whereas in dark field microscopy, we don't need staining, still we will get the contrast. Clear? Now, what is the specialty of dark field microscope? See, condenser lens does not permit direct transmission of light through specimen into objective lens. Okay, in bright field microscopy, we were using condenser lens to focus light on the specimen. Whereas here also, the condenser lens is having the same function, but with a variation. What is that? Condenser lens does not permit direct transmission of light through specimen into objective lens. Then what condenser lens is doing here? So in dark field microscope, it is provided with a dark field ring or dark field stop. That is a structure, an additional attachment or an additional fitting in dark field microscopy is, what is that? Dark field ring or dark field stop. Now what it is doing? It will focus light on the specimen at an oblique angle. What do you mean by oblique? Oblique means a tilted. Fine. It's like it is not straight. So in bright field microscopy, light will fall on the condenser lens. The condenser lens will directly focus the light on the specimen. Whereas in dark field microscopy, the condenser lens does not permit direct transmission of light through the specimen. Instead, it is provided with an additional attachment or fitting called dark field ring or dark field stop, which will focus the light on the specimen in a tilted angle, oblique angle. Fine. So that what happens? Only light that is reflected off the specimen enters the objective lens and seen. Okay, fine. So here in dark field microscopy, we will observe those light rays which are reflected off from the specimen. So again, what is reflection then? Reflection, we have studied in the last class. What is reflection? Bounce back of light from an object is called reflection. Now, what is the importance of reflection? As a result of reflection, the object appears in a particular color. Fine, already we discussed all those things. Fine. So here, coming back to our presentation. Now, in dark field microscopy, we visual or otherwise we will see those light rays which is reflected, which is only reflected from the specimen. We can't see any other light rays. Clear? That means only light that is reflected off from the specimen will enter the objective lens and seen. The next point, light passing through the rest of the slide will not enter the objective lens. So the light which is reflected will enter the objective lens, whereas all other light will just pass through. We cannot see any other light rays which is not reflected from the specimen. And as a result of this, the field appears dark, or the background appears dark, whereas the microorganisms appear very bright on a dark or black background. So that is the specialty of dark field microscope. That is, the field is dark and the specimen is bright. In bright field microscope, the field is bright and the specimen is dark or stained. So here, now you compare dark field with a bright field. First point, the same thing what I have told. In bright field microscopy, field is bright, specimen is dark or stained. Dark field microscopy, field is dark but specimen is bright and it is unstained even. We don't even need staining. Fine. Now, in bright field microscopy, condenser lens focus the light directly on the specimen into the through the objective lens, whereas in dark field microscopy, condenser lens will not permit the direct transmission of light through the specimen into objective lens. Fine. Then, what is the specialty of dark field microscope? It is having a special structure called dark field ring or dark field stop, which will focus light on the specimen at a oblique or tilted angle. As a result, what happens? Only light that is reflected off the specimen will only enter the objective lens of a dark field microscope and visualized. So light passing through rest of the slide will never enter the objective lens, and as a result the field appears dark or the background appears dark, and the microorganisms or the specimen or the slide which appears very bright on a dark or black background. So that's all about the second type of light microscope. So first of all, bright field microscope. Second one, now we learned about dark field microscope. Clear? Next slide, please. Thank you. So here you can see a condenser lens, and near the condenser lens you have got something called dark field ring or dark field stop. As a result, light source pass through the dark field stop through the condenser lens, reaches the specimen. So those lights which are going outside, you can see two arrows which is not reflected from the specimen are going outside, whereas you can see another two arrow which is reflected off the specimen will be entering through the objective lens, magnified, enter through the eyepiece, magnified, and reaches the eye. Clear? So that's all about the dark field microscope. Next slide. Next slide, please. Yeah, thank you. So this is how dark field microscope we can observe. Fine, the field appears very dark. You can see a black background, whereas the organism appears bright colored. You can see white colored. Clear? So what all things are over now? Bright field microscopy over, dark field microscopy. Next slide, please. Next, we move on to the third type of microscope, that is fluorescent microscope. Next slide, please. Thank you. So fluorescent microscope. Now, what is fluorescence? First of all, before going to the fluorescent microscope, last class we discussed all those things. That's why I discussed all these basic terminologies in the last class, so that you can very well understand in this class. So what is fluorescence? Light of one wavelength is absorbed and light of a different wavelength with low energy level is emitted. For example, fluorescent dyes, when illuminated with UV or ultraviolet light, will emit a color in the visible range. So we are providing a light under the ultraviolet range. So what was the ultraviolet range? It is about 100 to 400 nanometer. Once we are providing a light in the ultraviolet range into a fluorescent dye, it will emit a light in the visible range. So what was the visible range? 400 to 700 nanometer. Fine. So with this idea, we will pass on to the fluorescent microscope. Now, so when fluorescent dye is illuminated by light of one wavelength, that is, for example, UV light. Now, this is called excitation wavelength. So the light which we are using to illuminate the fluorescent dye will be having a wavelength called excitation wavelength. It gives off light at a different wavelength, that is emission wavelength. So UV light will be having a wavelength of around excitation wavelength, whereas visible light is having a wavelength of around emission wavelength. Clear? Very simple. When fluorescent dye is illuminated by light of one wavelength, for example, it is called excitation wavelength. So excited, fine. It gives off, fluorescent dye will gives off a light at a different wavelength, which is called emission wavelength. That means you have to understand like this. UV light is having a wavelength of around excitation wavelength, whereas visible light is having a wavelength of around emission wavelength. Clear? Now, for example for a dye. Fluorescein isothiocyanate is a dye which is illuminated with blue light, emits green light. So this is a dye. When we are providing blue light, it will emit green light. Okay. Now, what is another application of fluorescent microscope? Fluorescent dyes can be conjugated or linked with antibodies to identify specific microorganisms, and this technique is known as immunofluorescence. Immunofluorescence, a new term came. Fine. Fluorescent dyes can be linked or conjugated with antibodies to identify specific microorganisms, and this technique is called immunofluorescence. For example, if we have an unidentified pathogen, what we will do? We will make a slide. Fine. And we will go for a antibody conjugated fluorescent dye, and we will be staining the slide with the same dye, and we will observe. So here, what is happening? In case our mixture is having, so in fluorescent staining also you will be having some washing steps and all. Fine. So in case if our slide contains the particular antigen which we are looking, or the particular pathogen with the antigen which is complementary to the antibody, definitely the dye will attach with it and it will emit a fluorescent color, so that we can identify that the sample contains, the unidentified sample contains our target organism. So this is one technique. This technique is called immunofluorescence. Fine. Fluorescein isothiocyanate is a dye which is illuminated with blue light will emit green light. That is one point. Another point is dyes or fluorescent dyes which can be conjugated or linked with antibodies to identify specific microbes by a technique called immunofluorescence. So for this technique also we are using fluorescent microscope. Clear? Now it is having some additional, so for example in case of dark field microscopy we had an additional fitting called dark field ring or dark field stop. Fine. Here what we are having now, fluorescent microscope is equipped with excitation filters to permit passage of wavelength to illuminate the object, and barrier or emission filters to permit only emission wavelength to pass and prevent rest all. That means excited light must be of UV range and emitted visible light, and emitted light will be of visible range. So as a result, what happens? Barrier filter will prevent blindness by blocking UV from reaching the eye. So that is the application. So two types of filters are there in a fluorescent microscope. What are they? Excitation filter and emission filter. What is the purpose of excitation filter? Excitation filter will permit the passage of light rays to illuminate the object, for example UV. Excitation filter will only permit UV light to pass through it and illuminate the object. Now what is the purpose of emission filter or barrier filter? Emission filter or barrier filter will permit only emission wavelength to pass and prevent all other ones. That means emission wavelength is visible light, so emission filter or barrier filter will permit only the passage of visible light, and it will prevent all other light rays. So as I said, what is the application? Which means barrier filter or emission filter will prevent blindness by blocking UV from reaching the eye. So here in, for example, here in fluorescent microscopy we are using UV light to illuminate the object. In case by chance if UV light will come back and enter our eyes, what will happen? We will get blindness. In order to prevent this, we are having emission filter or barrier filter which will permit only the passage of visible light, so that whatever light is entering into our eye will be of the visible range and not in the excitation filter will only permit the passage of UV light. Fluorescent microscopes are there. What are they? Transmitted fluorescence and epifluorescence. So two types of fluorescent microscopes are there, transmitted fluorescence and epifluorescence. What is transmitted fluorescence? Here the excitation light is transmitted from below the specimen, or the UV light source will be below the specimen. That is transmitted fluorescence. And what about epifluorescence? The excitation light from above the specimen through the objective lens. That means in epifluorescence microscope, the UV light, the source of UV light will be from above the specimen through the objective lens. Two types of microscopes. Transmitted fluorescence, where the UV light source will be below the specimen, and epifluorescence microscope, where the UV light source will be above the specimen through the objective lens. Clear? That's all about fluorescence microscope. Not fluorescence microscope, sorry, fluorescent microscope. Clear? And the phenomenon, we call it as fluorescence. Next slide, please. Thank you. So this is about the picture of a fluorescent microscope. So here, where is the excitation filter? You can see the excitation filter. You can see the objective lens, the sample, the light source. So the light source is not from below the sample. It is from above the sample, which means this is epifluorescent microscope. Epifluorescent microscope. This is an example for an epifluorescent microscope. So you have an emission filter, you have an excitation filter, you have a camera, CCD camera to record this thing, ocular lens, all those things are there. Clear? This is the pathway, or this is a visualization of fluorescent microscope. Next slide, please. Thank you. So this is the way how a fluorescent microscope field looks like. You can see fluorescent color emitting by the sample. Fine. So now we have gone through three types of microscope: bright field microscope, dark field microscope, and fluorescent microscope. Next slide, please. Now we have maybe one or two microscopes remaining. Fine. Next slide, please. Thank you. So the fourth type of microscope we are going to learn today is phase contrast microscope. So what do you mean by phase contrast microscope? So we know what is bright field, we know what is dark field, we know what is fluorescent. Fourth type is phase contrast. Now here, first point, staining is not required to view microorganism. So here, so in dark field microscope also, we staining was not needed. In phase contrast microscope also, staining is not needed. In bright field microscope, staining is needed. And in fluorescent microscope also, staining is needed with fluorescent dyes. Clear? So in phase contrast microscope, staining is not required to view microorganisms, which is used to visualize live microorganisms. So phase contrast microscope is a type of microscope which we use to visualize live microorganisms. So here, what is happening? Light that passes through a cell or structure is slowed down relative to light that passes directly through the lens dense surrounding medium due to difference in diffraction. First point, clear? So when we are observing a slide, you will have a stained portion and you will have a unstained portion or clear slide. So when light is passing through the organism or the stained portion, definitely the light rays will be slowed down. Clean glass light, it will not be slowed down. Clear? Light that passes through a cell or structure is slowed down relative to light that passes directly through the less dense surrounding medium. So here we are not using staining, so we cannot talk about staining here. I'm sorry. So we are having some live microorganisms on a slide. When the light is passing through the cell, definitely it will slow down. Whereas when the light is passing through the nearby clean slide, it will not slow down when we are comparing the both. This is due to difference in diffraction. So what is diffraction again? Next terminology, diffraction. Diffraction is the broken up of light into different wavelength when passes through a fine opening or aperture. Okay, so when light is passing through something or a fine aperture or a small opening, it will broken up into different wavelength, that is called diffraction. Now the diffraction is a reason for the blurring of image in microscopy. Fine. So here, due to difference in diffraction, the light which is passing through a cell is slowed down when we are comparing with the light which is passing through a clear, less dense surrounding medium, that is the clean slide. Clear? Now, diffracted light by specimen passes through a region of face plate. So there is a structure in face contrast microscope called face plate. So what it is doing? Diffracted light by specimen passes through a region of face plate that alters its phase or its speed or its, fine. Now, the greater the refractive index of the cell or structure, the greater the retardation of light wave. Fine. Now, what is refractive index? Again, next terminology. So that's why yesterday these terminologies are very important. What is refractive index? Refraction. Refractive index is, what is that? Fine. Reflection, diffraction, absorption, fluorescence, refraction. Yeah, refractive index is the ratio of speed of light in a given medium to the ratio of speed of light in vacuum. So if we are passing light through a medium, what is the speed of the light? We are comparing when we are passing the same light wave through vacuum. Vacuum is nothing but without air. Okay, plus absence of oxygen, that is vacuum. So here what is happening? Now come back to our phase contrast microscope. The light which is diffracted by the specimen passes through a region of phase plate. Phase plate is a structure which is in phase contrast microscope. Clear? In dark field microscope, what we had? We had a dark field ring or dark field stop. In fluorescent microscope, we had excitation filter and emission filter or barrier filter. So here we have phase plate, an additional fitting or an additional structure. So diffracted light from by the specimen passes through a region of phase plate which alter its phase. Fine, its velocity we can tell. Phase means its speed or its velocity, whatever it is. Fine. Now, the greater the refractive index of the cell or structure, the greater the retardation of light wave. So if the refractive index of a cell is high, the light wave will be retarded to high extent. Whereas if the refractive index of a cell is low, the light wave will be retarded to less extent. That is the meaning. Fine. The greater the refractive index of the cell or structure, the greater the retardation of light wave. Clear. Now, finally, the differences in phase altered into differences in intensity, resulting in a visible difference in contrast between the specimen and the background. So, clear. Now, what is happening in phase contrast microscope? Very simple, I can explain. When we are focusing light on a slide, light will pass through the cell and also light will pass through the clean slide where we don't have any cell. Now, the light which is passing through the cell will be retarded, or the velocity of the light will be slowed down. When we are comparing it with the light which is passing through the clean slide, the light which is passing through the clean slide will move more faster than the light which is passing through the cell. So there is a difference in the phase, or there is a difference in the velocity. Now, the light which is passing through the specimen will also pass through a region of phase plate which will change its phase. That means it will change its velocity. Now, the greater the refractive index of the cell, the greater the retardation of light wave. For example, when it is passing through a cell, definitely the light wave will be retarded more than the light wave which is passing through the clean glass slide. As a result, there is a difference in phase. So when light is passing through the cell or when light is passing through the clean glass slide, there will be a difference in the phase or velocity, which is this difference is altered into difference in intensity of the light wave. As a result, you can observe the specimen or the live organism with the background. Fine. We can very well observe the organism in the background. Due to the difference in the phase, due to the difference in the velocity, due to the difference in the intensity of the light wave. Clear? For that purpose, the phase contrast microscope is provided with a structure called phase plate. That is a function of phase plate. Clear? That's all about phase contrast microscope. Next slide, please. So this is about phase contrast microscope. You have a phase plate you can see at the top, then refracted or diffracted light, that is phase altered by the specimen, pass through it. Fine. From the bottom, you will have a light source which will pass through the phase or unaltered by specimen. So that means When the light is passing through the specimen, it will change its phase. Whereas when the light is passing through the clean slide, it will not change its phase. Fine. This change in phase will be converted into change in intensity, change in contrast, and thus we can visualize the organism or the specimen. Excuse me. So that's all about phase contrast microscope. Next slide, please. So here in phase contrast microscope also, we can visualize an organism or a background like this. The background will be little dark in color, and also the organism will be comparatively not that much bright. It is not like light microscope or bright field microscope. In light microscope and bright field microscope, we can tell the field is bright and the object is dark, and in dark field, the field is dark and the object is bright. When it comes to fluorescent microscope, phase contrast microscope and all, the background will be comparatively always light in color, and you can visualize the organism. Clear? So here in phase contrast microscope, you can see the cell structure and some colored structures as well. Fine. All those things are light organisms. So whatever you see, the colored one, fine, white colored one, it will be the organism, live organism, whereas the other things will be the cell structures or whatever it is, which is in from the specimen. I am not sure which specimen is this. Could be some human skin or whatever it is. Fine. Clear? So now we have completed four types of microscope right from the beginning: bright field, dark field, phase contrast, and fluorescent. Clear? Next slide, please. So now we have got two types of microscope. Apart from this, the next one is Nomansky differential interference contrast microscope. Nomansky differential interference contrast microscope. Two more microscopes. By this, we will complete this session. Fine. So this Nomansky differential interference contrast microscope, short form, we can call it as NDIC. NDIC. It is also a type of light microscope. Clear? Now, so generally all these microscopes are light microscope. Why? Because the illuminating source is light, not electrons. Clear? Now, what is Nomansky differential interference contrast microscope, NDIC? Now, NDIC recombines light that passes through the specimen with light that does not pass through the specimen. Okay, so just before we learned about phase contrast microscope, there we had a phase plate which was mainly focusing in light which is diffracted from the specimen. Whereas in NDIC or Nomansky differential interference contrast microscope, we are considering all the light rays, which means the light which is passes through the specimen also we are considering, and the light which is not passing through the specimen also this particular microscope is considering. Fine. Now what happens? It produces interference. So what do you mean by interference? Any idea? So when two waves combine together, the two waves will interfere with each other, and it will increase the velocity or the power of the wave, which is called interference. So as a result of combination of light which passes through the specimen with light which does not passes through the specimen, interference is created, which alters the amplitude. Amplitude is energy of the light. Okay, that means the light wave is accelerated. The energy of the light wave is accelerated in this particular type of microscope. How they are accelerating? It considers both light rays which passes through the specimen and which is not passing through the specimen, and it will recombine these light rays. As a result, it produces interference and improves the amplitude or energy of the light wave. As a result, it leads to a difference in intensity and color. So it will lead to a difference in intensity and color. Then a high contrast three-dimensional image of unstained transparent specimens. So Nomansky differential interference contrast microscope or NDIC is a sophisticated microscope, ultra modern microscope, which will provide us a high contrast 3D image of unstained transparent specimen. So here the specimen can be unstained in nature, and the image which we are getting in NDIC eyes is 3D, three-dimensional in nature. And as microscope, it is having three special, a polarizing filter, say a particular type of filter, then an interference contrast condenser, it's also a special type of condenser, and a prism analyzer plate. So three types of specialized structures are provided for Nomansky differential interference contrast microscope, with which it combines the light which is passing through the specimen with light which is not passing through the specimen, and improves the interference and improves the amplitude, intensity, color, everything, finally produces a 3D image of unstained transparent specimens. Clear? Three features are there. What are they? A polarizing filter is there, an interference contrast condenser by which we will alter the interference and contrast, everything, and a prism analyzer plate. Fine. Now, what is another other applications of NDIC? Structures like cell wall and spores are well defined, so we can visualize very clearly the cell wall, spores, etc. are fine within a cell. Now, different structures of microorganisms appear in different color related to phase changes. Yeah, exactly. Because when light passes through a live microbial cell, it will be having different organelles like mitochondria, Golgi bodies, nucleus, cell wall, cytoplasm, all those things. So these different structures of a microbial cell will appear in different color due to the change in the phase. Clear? Now, brilliantly colored images can be obtained. Brilliantly colored images we can get it. Fine. Then, this particular microscope is useful for qualitative observation of unstained cells, as they produce high contrast images with striking topographic relief. So we are using this microscope is an ultra modern sophisticated equipment which is used for qualitative observation of unstained cells. So unstained cells can be properly observed. Even the internal structures like spores can be well defined. Okay, also it will produce a 3D image, three-dimensional image. It will produce brilliantly colored images. It produces high contrast images with striking topographic relief, which means we can see the topography, we can see the cell shape, arrangement, everything we can clearly visualize using NDIC or Nomansky differential interference contrast microscope. So you people has to focus four types of microscopes in detail. Already we have taken bright field, dark field, phase contrast, and fluorescent. Now this NDIC and all are some additional information which I am providing you. These are all sophisticated type of microscope. You may get some questions in your exam, or you may not get, because all those things are very new. So these four types of microscope you have to focus: bright field, dark field, phase contrast, and fluorescence. This way you have to focus very clearly, refer maximum and learn. And NDIC and all, just read and just keep it in mind, like you have got these types of microscopes. Clear? Yeah. Next slide, please. So this is the way by which light rays pass in NDIC. You have got a light detector. Then, so you just start from the bottom. You have a light source which is passing through a polarizing filter. Okay, then you have got a Nomansky prism, condenser lens, sample, objective lens. Then again, you have got two types of Nomansky prism on the top and bottom, which you are using to change the phase, everything. And then you have got a polarizing filter, and finally the light detector. Clear? Just for you to visualize how the light passes through NDIC. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Thank you. So this is the way, as I have explained, you can see very bright colored, high contrast, three-dimensional images of the specimen using NDIC, Nomansky differential interference microscope. Clear? Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Thank you. So this is the last type of microscope which we are going to learn today. Already we have learned about most important types of four, that is bright field, dark field, phase contrast and fluorescent, then NDIC. And the last one we are going to deal with today is confocal scanning microscope. And all these things are light microscope. So with confocal scanning microscope, we finish today's topic. And in the next session, we will deal about only about electron microscope. It's a second type of broad classification of microscope. Fine. Now, what is confocal scanning microscope? Here, this confocal scanning microscope also, it does not form a 2D image like conventional microscope. So here also, you are not getting and scan through the sample by two mirrors. One scans in X direction and other in Y direction. Oh, wonderful. This is also a very sophisticated ultra modern microscope. Fine. You have got a condenser lens which focuses light from a laser to a point. And you have got two types of objective lens here. So usually in a microscope, you have two types of lens, objective lens and ocular lens. Objective lens near the specimen, ocular lens eye, and then condenser lens which focuses the light. Here you have got two types of objective lenses. So what is the function of two types of objective lenses? Objective lens one will focus the light on a point, whereas objective lens two will scan. Fine. So a beam of light from a laser is focused to a point by objective lens one and scanned through the sample by two mirrors. Two mirrors are scanning it through the sample. This light wave, the light wave which is focused on a point, or the laser light which is focused on a point by objective lens one, is scanned through the sample by two mirrors. One scans in the X direction and other in the Y direction. Clear? So scanning is happening. Two, and a light detector is used to measure the interaction with each point in object during scanning. So all these scanned images, everything is detected by a light detector. So it is very complicated microscope. You have got a beam of light from a laser. Fine. Objective lens one will focus light on a point. This focused light is scanned through the sample by two mirrors. Mirror one scans in the X direction and mirror two scans in the Y direction. After scanning, the second objective lens will magnify the scanned image, which is detected by the light detector. Clear? Now, only light from a specific point of focus in specimen is detected. So, complete specimen is not detected. In the specimen, we are observing a particular area or particular point of the specimen which is magnified. So you will be getting a clear picture of that area, not the entire specimen. Clear? Now, other diffracted light rays are eliminated to avoid image blur. So whatever scanning light will only enter the objective lens 2 and magnified and detected by the light detector. All other lights which are not scanned and all other light rays which are diffracted will be eliminated or avoided so that no image blur will happen. We will get a clear image. Fine. So for that, what are all the structures present in this microscope? Confocal fluorescent scanning microscope. That is, you will get a property of fluorescent also there. Confocal fluorescent scanning microscope uses an excitatory laser light. So excitation filter, you remember in which one? Fluorescent microscope, excitation means which is used to illuminate the object. So here, this particular microscope, that is confocal fluorescent scanning microscope, uses an excitatory laser light, passes through an excitation filter, the same like fluorescent microscope, then reflected by dichroic mirror. It is a type of our condenser lens, reflected by a dichroic mirror, focused by objective lens 1 on a point within the specimen. Then this light is scanned across the specimen by two mirrors. Finally, objective lens 2 will magnify the scanned image, and the scanned images are used to generate optical sections of fluorescent dye labeled specimen to produce a three-dimensional image with absence of out of focus blur. So this is the altogether phenomena happening. So finally, what we are getting, we are getting only the image of scanned light or scanned image we are getting. And if you are using fluorescent dye, so you can even observe fluorescence, fine. And the image will not be 2D or two-dimensional, it will be definitely 3D. So three-dimensional image means more details we can observe, fine. And since we don't focus any light which is not scanned by the objective lenses or the mirrors, so that there is no out of focus blur, no blurring of image will happen, fine. Then last point, specimen is either in focus with internal structures visible or out of focus so that absolutely no structures are seen. So this is the important feature of confocal microscope. So if the specimen is in focus, for example, if the light is pointed within the specimen, you can observe specimen in focus with internal structures visible. Or if the specimen, if the laser light is pointed out of focus, in that case out of focus so that absolutely no structures are seen, you won't see anything in out of focus specimens. Clear? This is the most important feature of confocal microscope. Clear? So this is also two types of sophisticated microscopes we have learned, in addition with four types of routine bright light microscopes. What are they? NDIC, Nomarski differential interference scanning microscope, confocal fluorescent scanning microscope. Clear? Next slide, please. So this is the way light rays pass in confocal fluorescent scanning microscope. Fine. You have got out of focus light which is completely out. Focal plane, you can see the specimen. Objective lens and dichroic mirror. Fine. You can see the laser light. Also the detector and confocal pinhole. Fine. Just to show the path of light in confocal fluorescent scanning microscope. Next slide, please. So here you can see a picture how we are observing the specimen. So you can see a light field where they have, so the total specimen is not like this. It will be the point of the specimen where the mirrors have scanned the specimen. So so that you can see the clear internal structures and everything. So with this microscope, today's session comes to an end. And over to the organizers, and the session is now open for discussion. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for this informative session. I hope it help. It really helps students to understand the aspects of microscope. Sir have explained about different microscopes. So many external information sir have already shared. And you know, we all have few memories with microscope, like while working in laboratories, breaking slides, glass slides, breaking cover slips. So we all have some beautiful and cute memories with microscope. Yes, sir.
Exactly. So whenever we are learning this topic, we have to learn little from the imagination also, how we were using microscope. So how we were focusing a specimen, all those things we had to recollect and then read the presentation, then we can get it very clearly. Thanks.
So now I would like to request students, if you have any queries, you can ask. you have any queries, you can ask here. Thank you, Athira, Priyanka Arora. Informative session. Thank you, Rishita. And Jancy CH is asking, sir, how different organelles appear different color in unstained cells, as you told in NDIC microscope. Here, no dyes are used.
Which microscope is that?
NDIC microscope.
NDIC. Okay. Fine.
You can read the questions in the comment box, sir.
NDIC, let me check. NDIC, it is. Phase means you have to understand that the speed of the light or the path of the light will be slowed down or altered. So the light, when it is passing through the nucleus, will be altered in a different way than the light rays which is passing through the cytoplasm. So this, due to this difference in phase changes, you can visualize these cells in different color. It is not the same. It is not staining. It is the phase changes which play the role there.
Okay, sir. And any questions? Any few more questions?
So what I suggest is, since we have discussed about all these 4 or 5 microscope, please go through all these materials. Anyway, you will be sharing this material with all of them. Please go through this material. And you will have doubts, you can come back with doubts in the next session also, no problem. Because you have to read everything, then only you will get some doubts actually. Just by hearing, we cannot get that striking difference actually. And even you can refer. I have referred around 2 or 3 textbooks like Prescott and some other textbooks, whatever we have, even internet and all. So you can also refer about all these microscopes. Even in nowadays, collection of references is very easy. You can use Google, you can use online textbooks, whatever it is. So when you, if you are referring it, you will get more and more informations, better informations than this. So in that case, if you have got some doubt, you can come back with the doubt. Even you can ask now, and you can ask in any other class. Even in my first class, if you have got any doubt, please let me know. So I will try my level best to clear all those things. Thank you.
Okay, sir. That's all for today's class. I request our organizer, Mr. Amit, to please put the attendance link in the comment box. Once again, thank you, Vinay, sir.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. See you next class.
Thank you, sir. Welcome. I request organizer to please put the link in the comment section. I request every student to please fill the attendance form. No one is allowed to leave the meeting without filling. Arohi, Arusi, Akshita Sakshi, Alisa Ansari, Arunima, Asi, Athira, Bhavani, Sridharan, Bhumika, Vikas, Dipan Vita Seth, Divya, JNCCS, Kasika, Kavita Bhumreddy, Khan Sahesta, Jamal Akhtar, Prayusi Nandi, Preeti Kumari, Priyanka Arora, Rajiv Ranjan, Rishita Parihar. I request everyone to be connected with us and attend every class. Sakshi Priya, Saleha Qureshi, Sara Hassan, Sarita Dev Narayan Gupta, Sayali Sudhir Sikar, Sherin Razu Siba, Smriti Goyal, Srivalli Kola, Sriya Mitra, Sunidhi Chauhan. I request everyone to please be connected with us and attend every session. And please fill the attendance form also, so that we can notify our regular attendees. Hope you are doing great in your life and stay safe, stay home. Don't go out without carrying sanitizer and mask. Stay safe in the home. So sir has suggested some books for you. You can go through the books like Prescott microbiology books. So those who have filled the attendance form, they can leave the meeting. And those who do not fill the form, please fill the form. It is compulsory. And thank you for your tremendous support for registering and joining every session. I will provide all the PowerPoints in your group so that you can go through. And at last, I request our organizer, Mr. Amit, after 2 or 3 minutes, you can stop the program. We have only 15 students left.
Yes, Amit. Amit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think all are filling the attendance form. You just need to leave this meeting.
Okay. Thank you.